السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته والصلاة والسلام على رسوله الكريم. I'll be quick and to the point. A few days back, a sister emailed me saying that perhaps I did disrespect the African-American in doing my khutbah. And my response to her was, are you sure that was me? Because indeed, I do have a tremendous respect and great respect for African-Americans, especially for what they did for the immigrants who came after them. It was them who died, it was them who been killed for their freedom and their struggle. And their struggle should be appreciated and celebrated, not to be condemned and disrespected. So the sisters, after that, she sent me a link saying, this is what you said, Jazakallah khair, in the most polite way. And I do appreciate Sister Aisha. I don't even know her last name or second name, but I do appreciate you sending me that. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you. What I'd like to say here, number one, the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us who we are and what we are when he said, "Kull ibn Adam khata," every single one of you would make a mistake. Every single son of Adam would make a mistake. And I am one of those people. I cannot testify what I said. And what I said in a nutshell was that I brushed all African Americans being, or majority African Americans being, one night stand. That is unfair and incorrect. But we also know something called zallat al-lisan. Sometimes you say something when you're on the member and you're talking and you're addressing congregation, and your mind is thinking in a high speed manner, and you don't know, you know, what to say maybe or what would come. I don't know how I said it and when I said it, because nobody ever brought that subject to me, even though the khutbah happened, you know, a month ago, because it was not my intention. So from here, I sincerely apologize if I offended anybody regarding this. I lived in America, I lived in Canada, I live in Canada, and I know what African Americans still go through. And I can guarantee you, we share the same thing with you, because when the police officers, when they stop us, we all panic, because they don't differentiate whether you're African American or you're African. To them, you are one. And for me to come around and disrespect that community, it is unfair and is not my intention and it's not in my belief at all. Those of you who know me know better than that and know that I am not that kind of person. When I was growing up and when I was coming to this da'wah, my role models, people who helped me, people who made me understand this deen better, people that I used to follow, I used to listen to them, people I used to go to the khutbah and lecture, people I used to, you know, take them role models in this deen, was mainly African Americans. They were not Somalis, they were not Yemenis, they were not Algerians, they were African Americans, because I admire them. I admire their struggle, I admire what they did. And I have tremendous respect for people like Abu Usama al-Dhahabi, رَفَعَ اللَّهُ مَقَامَهُ وَغَفَرَ اللَّهُ ذَنْبَهُ وَسَلَ اللَّهُ أَنْ يَحْشُرَ تَحْتَ زُمْرَةِ النَّبِيِّ مُحَمَّدٍ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ يَوْمَ لَا يَنْفَعُ مَالٌ وَلَا بَنُونَ. He's and his likes were people who we used to listen and learn from them. Oh, we still do. Absolutely, we still do. I have great respect for MashaAllah Tabarakallah Siraj Wahaj. We grew up listening to him. Hafidhahullah wa barakallahu fi. So no one can say Saeed is, you know, you're prejudiced or you. No, I'm not that kind of people. However, as we said, there's like something called zallat al-lisan, the slip of the tongue. You may want to say something, but something it may come out wrong. In this matter, people usually are three categories when something like this happens. Those who just move on, whether they know you're better or they don't think it's, you know, big deal. And those who will give you sincere nasiha, say, Brother Saeed, you know, you did this, can you correct it? Which what I'm doing right now. And those who will take advantage of the situation and play around and, you know, add some sensation, you know, and fights. And they all know, by the way, some of these people who are writing, they know my number. They know how to contact me. They know how to, you know, where to find me. Like others did, they chose to go to the net and, you know, and play hero. And the funny thing, you know, these people, some of them, when they were being grilled, when they were being torn apart, we were the people who were defending them. But you know, in Arabic they said, إِلَّا الْحَمَاقَةِ أَعْيَتْ مَنْ يُدَوِيَ. If the people, you know, in their thinking are, and if they not intelligent, you can't really help. Al-hamaqa is stupidity. And simply, this poem, he said, you can cure any illness, you can cure anything except stupidity. It will make the person who tried to cure it ill. You know, Ali ibn Abi Talib, a man came to Ali ibn Abi Talib, he said, yeah, Ali, I know Abu Bakr has been appointed as a Khalifa of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, but guess what? I can bring an army who can stand behind you so you can take the Khilafah. Ali ibn Abi Talib, he looked at him, قَالَ يَا هَذَا أَلْمُؤْمِنُونَ النَّصَحَ وَالْمُنَافِقُونَ غَشَشَ فَأَيُّهُمَا أَنْتَ. He said, listen to me. True believers, they give advice. True believers, they tell, you know, brother, this is my, you my brother, you my ticket to Jannah, I'm your ticket to Jannah, you know, I am your mirror, this is the mistake that you did, you know, please correct it. That is the attitude of a mu'min. But the munafiq, he said, غَشَشَ, you know, they speak around those people. They talk about them, they, you know, because he's a munafiq, what else do you expect? And they don't even know the basics of Amr bil Ma'ruf. They don't even know the basics of Nasiha, because we know Hadith of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam when he said, Ad-deenu Nasiha. This deen that you claim, that you adapted, you took it, and is part of your life, it's based on advice, not based on ishar. You know, there's a difference between ishar al-ayb or nasihat al-muslim. There's a difference between you, you know, exposing the faults of a Muslim or and giving a nasiha. And whether that mistake was happened on in a public place or it happened in a private place, your responsibility as a Muslim is to give a nasiha. If the person becomes arrogant and he doesn't want to take your nasiha, you're entitled then to come out and say, you know, this is 1, 2, 3, and you know, I gave my brother nasiha, he was not listening, I need to clarify this. But some people did not do that because I believe they may fall under the category when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talked about those who like fahisha, you know, bad publicity, to be over a certain people, who like to talk about others, write about others. And Allah said, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ يُحِبُّونَ أَن تَشِيعَ الْفَاحِشَةُ فِي الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. Those who love the fahisha, to be around those who believe in Allah. Allah said, لَهُمْ عَذَابٌ. Allah will punish them in this dunya and akhirah. وَاللَّهُ يَعْلَمُ أَنْتَ. And Allah knows and you do not know. So my nasiha to myself is, number one, to be careful what I should say. And I will also give nasiha to anybody, anyone who is in my position, is to be careful to what we may say, because you cannot brush everybody with one brush. That statement that came out of my mouth, it was a wrong statement, because it's not right. I know a decent, most decent family, you know, I mean the most decent in terms of a perfect picture family, you know, who are from that community, mashallah, tabarakallah. So I don't think and I don't believe all African Americans were the product of one night stand. That is not logic. And anybody who's trying to argue with me or argue that is the case, he's really not intelligent enough to understand what he's standing on. The second nasiha that I would give to الَّذِينَ يُحِبُّونَ أَن تَشِيعَ الْفَاحِشَةُ فِي الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا, those who likes to, you know, sensationalize the things and mistakes of others. Remember, you know, لا يجوز الشماتة على الإخوان. You know, you're not allowed to, you know, make fun or try to take advantage of a mistake of others. Why? Because perhaps you were in their position once, or perhaps you will be in their position, because if they made a mistake, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, by default, Allah will not hold them accountable. Allah will hold us accountable when we do things intentionally. In a nutshell, I would say to my brothers and sisters in the African American community, really, I did live in America, and I know the struggle that you go through. We went through when we were there. The police would stop us, and they didn't care from whether from Africa or from actual African American. So I know the struggle that you go through. I know the struggle that we all go through, we still go through as a black people, as a color, people of color. So it's not my position to disrespect my own community, because you are my own community in all level. My community in terms of the struggle, my community in terms of, you know, race, my community in terms of how we perceive. And some of you are my community based on my our religion. So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to show us the truth, show us the haqq. And I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive me for what I said. And I sincerely apologize to my brothers and sisters in the African American community. May Allah bless you. And for those who play the nifaq card, who those who like to do the isha'at al-fahisha bayna al-mu'mineen, I advise them to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because that is not the behavior of a mu'mineen. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.